You know what I'm talking about, though? People are like, I have to go get surgery on an ingrown toenail. I'm like, what? I really don't understand. It seems like, couldn't they just cut that out themselves? It was like just a toenail, you just go, pull it out, done. Because maybe, I think I might have gotten an ingrown toenail from that. All I did is I just cut it out myself. I mean, I was bleeding from it, but I was like, whatever. It hurt, so I just went, I did it with my own fingers. Is that gross? Because I was like, ow, this thing keeps hurting, so I just grab it and I go, yanked it out, and then I never had a problem again. But I think I might have had an ingrown toenail there, but I don't think you really need to see a doctor for it. But maybe I have that pain threshold thing where it doesn't bother me, probably. I'm bleeding a little bit. Who cares? I think I took care of mine before it would have. It's probably because I pulled mine out and yanked it out. I didn't cut it. Oh yeah, mine had grown back, but then it grew back and it kind of hurt a little bit, so I just pulled it out, pulled it apart, and it was done. I don't know, I can never tell. It seems like a lot of people are really wussy.
Yeah, I agree.
I remember in high school, you want to hear something sort of funny? And weights, you know, we had like lifting partners, and I was always with like Denny and like the older guys, you know, because I could lift as much as them. And one of the days during deadlift, I pinched my finger in between two weights right here on my index finger or pointer finger, and I got a blood blister. It just like happened. I was like, oh man, oh, but I need to lift, and that's gonna hurt. So I went like this. I just went ahead and bit it. I'm like that, and they didn't know that I got a blood blister. So they just think I'm biting my finger and then I'm going to go lift. They just see me bite my finger and blood come out. And they're like, what's wrong with you? And I'm like, ah. And I lift it and I picked it up because it was a heavy, heavy weight. It was like, I don't know, 500 or something. It's like, dude, you're messed up in the head. You just bit yourself and you lift it. I just went along with it. I was like, yep, that's how I get pumped up. Gotta taste the blood. Yeah, I still get that when I lift heavy. That's just called intensity, it's called focus, I don't know. I get my vein popping out. I do think, in that sense, football is good for people, or especially for young men, because it allows like some of their aggression to like be let out. You know what I mean? Because you're going through all those changes and you have all the testosterone and hormones going through your body. I think they just might be dumb. Just be mean, but... See how I see it. Or I think they might also try to play up that stereotype, too. We're the country boys. We like to hit stuff. Or, you know, however they talk. It is funny that the black guy on their team is the one that was like the worst. I think in this next challenge, this one right here, I think if there's a lot of water or any water stuff, that's where the football players will probably lose. They suck on the water. But on land, man, those guys are pretty quick.
Yeah.
They cover a good amount of ground. Who do you think? I don't really think blind team has a chance of winning. I don't think they really have a chance of winning, even though that guy cut his cast off, but still. Well, I don't see them beating the gypsies, because most even when they were, like, fine, they weren't really beating the gypsies ever, you know? It's funny that the Fab 3, like that one dude's like, oh, you cheering for your friends, huh? And the guy answers back, he's like, dude, how can you not cheer for him? One guy's blind, the other guy can barely walk. How do you not want them to just win? Well, you know what I mean? Like, he just kind of threw that guy to the blaze. It made me laugh. Because he has a point, how can you not cheer for them, honestly? That guy's a jerk, man. Why would you even want to be around him? The other guy doesn't really even really talk much. I don't think I've ever really heard him say much, have you? Well, even on those little interviews that they do, he doesn't really say much. You know what I mean? They always are focusing on the stupid gay guy. The other guy doesn't say anything. Have you really heard him ever? I think the cops were easily forgettable. They weren't, you notice how they weren't really, Yeah, they didn't focus on them at all. Other than this last race, I didn't even know the cops were even in the race. That's how much they focused on them, to me. You know what I mean? Because they're very forgettable. There's nothing like... They don't really have... larger than life personalities, I would say. The fishermen, I don't think, I'm surprised they lasted as long as they did. I wish I'd seen the first few episodes and seen the New York girls with their high heels. That's funny. They have their tanks, their curlers and stuff to plug in the wall sockets or whatever. It just sounds really funny. Like, I probably did that knowing that it'd be funny first episode. I'm talking about like the season premiere of that would just like be memorable, because you know they're testing the waters with this new thing they're trying out. Because this is the first season of it, right? I don't know how they could make another season, honestly.
Yeah, because what really made it was the buying team. The
gypsies
are, yeah, they
make it. All, but there's nothing great about them.
No.
There's nothing that draws a crowd about it. They seem like nice guys, but yeah, there's nothing like... There's nothing that makes you want to watch them.
Yeah.
Cool, they did it. Oh, the No Limits team? Because it's interesting. Because that guy's got a messed up leg, and the other guy's blind. It's like, how can you not want to watch that? This blind guy just skydived.
He
just went down some river rapids.
Yeah. He makes the show, I think.
Which one? I think they're both kind of... I think that team's kind of made up of a good group of... interesting characters.
And the one that holds it together is the one that, hey, you know, extra nice guy.
Yeah, that guy, he's like super positive and nice to like everybody. He's not like a jerk or anything.
Yeah.
It's like, good job, yeah, I'll see you guys when we get to the finish line. Weird, like even closing my eyes and walking around here right now just seems weird. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm sure you figure. I'd say pretty much we all focus on our visual cues than anything other sense. What'd you say? I'm just saying in general, we all focus on our visual cues than any other sense.
Yeah.
I wasn't talking about hiking and touching things. If something looks gross, I'm not going to eat it. Although, I guess music has a huge impact on our society too, though. So hearing is a big thing too. Like, I don't think smells much up there. you're out in the wilderness, let's say back in the olden days, you really couldn't survive without your vision. Without your sight. There's no chance. I mean, say you're out there by yourself, there's no chance you could survive. Because what? How do you know what to eat? Or maybe you could go near water, but how do you eat? You could drink the water, but...
I wouldn't know if there was a dead animal.
Yeah, I mean, you got to taste it. I mean, even if you can see it, it doesn't mean it's still clean, but I'm just saying overall, if you don't have your sense of sight, I don't think you're going to survive. You could go without hearing and be okay.
Yeah.
You got smell, you'd be okay. Taste, you'd be okay. Touch, you'd be okay, but eyes seem to be a good thing to have. This is survival, I mean. He pretty much just holds on to him and goes wherever he goes. I wonder how they met. That's what I always wonder too. I'm assuming that guy's, they're in their 30s, I'm assuming. And I remember him saying they'd known each other for about 20 years. So I'm thinking at age 10 they met each other. Or high school. Somewhere around there, I'm thinking, right? And then sometime in the mid-20s is probably when they did Everest. Because that kid's guy's got, the blind guy's got a 10-year-old and an 8-year-old at home, I remember. I doubt if he'd go to Everest if he has kids. Yeah, but Everest is more of risk. This time he has all these camera crews around him and stuff. If he gets in that trouble, they can help him. You know what I mean? There's a lot less danger involved here than there is on Everest. Well, you know what I mean? I think as far as danger goes, I think there's less danger doing this than there is doing Everest. Because you have more people around you that can help. They have a helicopter, I mean, they could just call in at any moment's notice and probably fly you out there.
Yeah.
Everest, you can't fly or anything up there. Just, if you're hurt, you're screwed, kind of. Really short. Cause this is I see dog prints on the ground and stuff, so I know we're easily on that trail. The dog is. Hours of hike up it, 1 hour to get back down it. I've only come across two snakes this entire time I've been hiking, and it's been in the last 2 days. One was on the Bell Trail, a big old snake went by. And the other one was at Slide Rock, there's a small snake swimming around trying to eat fish. Like a little baby one, maybe like a tiny little foot long one, going after little baby fish. Which is kind of interesting, you think I would see more, you know? I've seen squirrels when I was hiking Muskork a lot, just so many squirrels. On the top. top of the Red Rocks on the way up there, which is kind of cool because it's a weird contrast to have, you know, you have all these red rocks and you're up there in the canyon and then there's a blue jay right next to you. Super blue. I saw a dead raccoon on the road one day. That doesn't really count. Oh, did, and one of the, and I actually hiking West Fork, those black birds, I think they're crows or are they ravens? I don't know what they're called exactly. The crows? I think I was around their nest, that's why they're dive bombing me. I mean, I was just following the trail, but I'm like 10 miles down the trail on this river area, and these stupid crows start dive bombing me in my helmet. And it happened to be when I was trying to switch the battery out on my camera. So I have a little footage of them. It'll just show up randomly on a hike. Dude, this dude's getting attacked by birds. Kind of funny. I don't know. What are the chances of that, you know what I mean? Do you think Daniel will be able to find? That actually surprises me. I just don't see him being a... I just don't see a counselor first and foremost. I don't know why. Because he hates people, kind of. Or he's burnt out with them right now. These people are going to come in and tell him all his problems. He's going to be like, what is wrong with the world? He's sleeping with two women and he's married and has five kids. Or, well, you know what I mean? I thought he'd be burned out on that. They're both PAs and they haven't paid off their student loans. They're like $500,000 in debt or something. Something like that. Well, each of them like has like $140,000 of student loan debt still. And well, they have a mortgage, they have three kids. It seems like they don't try to muck out the problem. They go to India and their house, the house they live in, I was just recently over at their house, it's like a freaking mansion. Their yard is like as big as our house and they have like half the yard's as big as the house. And they have like a pool as big as like a pool you'd see like at a public area, like the Clarkdale pool. And their kitchen's about as big as the karate school was. If that gives you an idea, that's just their kitchen. Like, their house is huge. They just got it like a year ago, but I'm thinking it's got to be close to $500,000 for that house. Well, I think they got it in foreclosure, but it was probably priced at like 1.2 or something, because this house is huge. And the property is huge. And it's a surprise. This house is like, it's seriously probably one of the nicest houses I've ever been in. It didn't even make sense. It's like, what the heck? One of their rooms is like the size of a house. That's what I mean, like, it doesn't seem like they're trying to get out of debt. Why would you go and buy something like that when you have all that other debt on top, you know what I mean? I thought you had to pay back your student loans. You tend to declare bankruptcy. That's one of the things that they... I think they could come after you for that. Take your house or whatever, I don't know. I know a lot of teachers aren't able to pay back for student loans because they don't get paid enough. They can't live and pay back for student loans. You know what I mean? Like, because if you'd be a teacher, they acquire a master's degree? That's ridiculous. So they have to go get a master's degree and then they're like, dirt. Broke then after doing all that, and they get paid pennies, and their salary's getting cut more by the government. Seems, ooh, seriously, I think to be a teacher nowadays, I don't think you're very smart. Not to be mean, but is that the kind of person you want teaching your kids? Maybe it's just not my thing. I just don't see the benefit of being really broke and poor and having your parents yell at you because their kids don't. Well, I mean, they have to deal with parents that are dumber than they used to be, I feel, too. It's everybody else's fault but the parents on why their kid sucks. Because I have karate, like, teachers, like, they can't say anything or really tell parents how it really is, because then they'll get reported and lose their job. Like, yeah, Jimmy over there was punching three kids, and he does this all the time. What do you mean my kid does that? I'm talking to your principal. And principal, they get chewed out for what their kids do. It's so dumb. I don't know, maybe I could find satisfaction. Yeah, I don't really care about that stuff. I think it's smarter to... I think it's... If I was gonna ever go and have... I would never buy a jet ski or buy a boat. I would just rent it, because the amount that I'm gonna use it would be like once a year. If that. That's how I feel about stuff like that. RVs, well... I'm iffy on the RV thing because I want a tour, and it'd be really nice to have an RV than to rent one, because I don't know if you've gone and looked some places like that cruiseamerica.com, you know, you see driving around sometimes. They charge you, well, first you have to put a deposit down of like however much the RV's worth. That's like something like that. You have to put down a deposit. Then you have to get insurance, and then every day you rent it, depending on like, their standard one was like $300 a day to rent, and they charge you $2 for every mile that you drive, and you have to pay for your own gas. So right there, that's a whole lot of money. You just sunk into something that you're renting. I priced it out, it'd actually be cheaper to buy than to rent an RV right now. Because you can resell it later too. But then it costs, the initial investment though is a little bit, the initial investment on RV though is more than the initial investment on renting an RV. But over a year period of like a year or two though, you'd end up actually on top. RV's a little more comfortable. Well, if you think about it like this, okay, so if you travel, you have an RV, you have at least a fridge you can keep food in, so you can cook your own meals, and that ends up saving you money. Hard to gauge how resilient he is. What's the big program? It's one of those. Like they have to walk the wider stance and be out here more.
Well,
over and shuffle, if you have the shuffle walk on, you know. But as soon as he sees a pattern on the floor, he immediately straightens up and walks normal by following the pattern. He's trying to figure out how it works with the human mind, how come it works on this guy, and how to make it maybe patterns like glasses that people with Parkinson's could wear, and then he'd be walking normal. Like, that dude, seriously, you can see him go from to looks normal, walks straight, looks around straight, and functions like a young person would. Well, it's just weird, it's just a pattern thing in the brain, and they came across this because there was tiles on the floor, and this guy that had Parkinson's all of a sudden started walking normal when he was looking at the tiles. It only works in like 60% of patients. This little pattern, this pattern thing. But you can check it out, it's online. I saw it because it was in my biology class. They happen to have a thing on Parkinson's. I thought it was interesting. I was like, that's crazy. Because it literally looks like he's like, shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. He literally goes, he looks up, looks at the camera, and then he just starts walking normal. But then as soon as he gets to the end of that little pattern, then he's back shuffling again. And he goes back around the circle, and he's back around, he's walking normal again. When he sees the pattern. They're trying to figure out how the heck that's linked, like the patterns, how the pattern's helping him, or why is the pattern helping him of all things when it's in his basal nuclei that is being slowly destroyed. You'll see it and be like, that's so weird. That's how I'm like, whoa, that's weird. I know that this is already, this is like a 2 or 3 year old video that I saw. But would they be able to focus on where they're going and focus on the pattern? Like, I don't know. I don't know. Obviously, they're doing research and stuff on it. They're not just like sitting back and being like, oh, cool. So maybe something came about from it. I know it didn't work on every single patient, it just worked on some. Or maybe after a certain period of time it doesn't work anymore, or I don't know. Yeah, Ben, but he doesn't really have the shit. I noticed he's got a little in his fingers sometimes. Bad. But overall, yeah. But doesn't that develop later, though? I think it probably has to do with the stuff Dad was exposed to when he was younger, because he always talked about how he used to like wash his hands in gasoline and stuff, and that goes into your skin, which then would get into your... Oh, really? I don't know. Well, I think maybe Dad could be more susceptible to it than Grandma had worked with him. And by doing certain outside environmental things can help trigger those. I know they say with cancer, most people that come from a background of cancer, they might not get cancer because of how they've kept track of their environmental conditions. You know, I'm talking about, like, say someone that has a history of heart disease in their family, if they do lots of cardio and they keep track of what they're eating, well, they're not going to have heart disease. Where someone who has no history of heart disease can eat crappy food all the time, and suddenly get heart failure. wrist or